Okay, good day, everybody. Okay, today we'll be moving on to the second part of electricity, whereby we look at the different formations of the circuitry. Example, like if you arrange the circuit in the series formations or parallel formations, or how about mixture formation? Okay, so when you have different layout, how is the resistance, volt, potential difference, and the current going to change? Okay, we'll look at in details how are the variables, the three variables, the potential difference, the resistance, the current, how would they change when the formation is a different formation is being used. Okay, so now let's refer to the slides that I'm going to use, or you can refer to your textbook. It's roughly the same layout. Okay, now the first setting that we have here will be on series circuit. Okay, the idea of a series circuit and parallel circuit, they are the two common arrangement that we have. We look at the first one here and series circuit. Series circuit, how do you recognize a circuit when they are in series, or the components are connected in series as compared to parallel? The common one that I always tell my student is, for series arrangement, you always have the components connected together side by side. Okay, all side by side. Okay, on the left or on the right of each other. Okay, between, they are actually connected by a cable. Okay, by the same cable connected to each other. For parallel arrangement, it's easier to identify, whereby the components are connected by two separate cable, but they are connected in the up and down arrangement. Okay, up and down arrangements. Okay, that's how I identify by parallel arrangements. Okay, some of the common things that you have, some of us may say that, I will know it's a series arrangement because, okay, maybe the current will flow through them. Okay, or there is only one path for the current to flow through. How do I know it's a parallel arrangement? Because the current will flow different path. Okay, so if I know the current flow at different path, that particular arrangement will be a parallel arrangement. If it's the same direction, same path, it will be a series arrangement. Okay, so let's look at the first one, series arrangement. Okay, same thing, series arrangement. The ammeters are connected in series with the component. This is ammeter 1 and ammeter 2. They are connected in series. Why? Because the same cable is connected through it, each and every one of the electrical components here. Okay, so now in the series circuit, so what are the common things that we have? Okay, series circuit, like I mentioned before, the components are connected together in a loop, and because they are connected in a single loop, you'll find that the same current actually will flow throughout the components, and because of that, the ammeters flowing through the circuit, whether it's A1, whether it's before the component, but it's after the components, okay, A2, they will actually have the same reading because the same current actually flow through a series circuit. Okay. Now, what happens when you have more components connected in series? Example, your resistance 1 and resistance 2. They are connected in series. Okay, so here what we have is we have a series 1, resistor 1, and resistor 2, they are in series. How do I know they are in series? Because they are connected side by side. And there's a common path for the current to flow through, which is I1 will flow through all the way, I3 and I2. You'll find that all the current will have, all the ammeter will have the same current because the current actually flow through a single path. The current actually follows a single path. Okay, which is from here all the way up and back to the power source again. So there's a single path and there is no alternative path. There's no split path for the current. So I know this is a series arrangement. And because it's series arrangement, the current, your I1, I2, and I3, okay, will be the same. The only thing that's different between this circuit, let's take a look at the previous circuit and this previous circuit, you'll find that there's only one resistor here. And in here, you have two resistors here. Okay, so because there are resistors, there's one more additional resistor here, you'll find that the resistor, okay, will actually be doubled. Okay, we will, for this discussion, because it's quite a basic course that we are looking at, so we will skip the derivation, we will skip the mathematics behind the proving of the resistance in series. So we will just take it as the, I will just let you know the final outcome is whereby they are in series. the resistance will actually add up. So for series, the resistance will add up. So if I have two resistors, means my resistance actually increase, it will actually double. So like I mentioned in the previous topic, resistance and current, they have an inverse relationship. The higher the resistor, the lower my current. So if my resistance actually doubled in this case, okay, my current will actually be half straight away. Okay, so this is what we mean by the characteristic of the relationship between the resistance and current. And here what we have is I add in the arrangement, series arrangement, because the resistor are in series arrangement, the resistor has doubled, and because they are doubled, the relationship between R and I would still follow, will still exist, because now I doubled, my current will be half. Okay, for potential difference, okay, it will be even more straightforward. Okay, it will just be adding up of everything. Okay, because eventually the potential difference for the whole entire circuit here, let's say V1, V2, the potential difference, okay, the energy needed for each component is actually provided by who? By the power source. So which means the potential difference of the power source or the energy of the power source is actually equivalent to the energy supplied to both of the sources, both of the loads. Okay, what we call a simple conservation of energy. Meaning whatever energy I have at a total will be actually used up by the energy of one and energy of two of the resistor one and resistor two. It's just that maybe here in circuit, we look at, instead of looking at energy, I will look at the energy carried by a single charge, which we always call it potential EMF or the battery, or potential difference of the battery. Whatever I produce will be used up by the voltage of the component, the potential difference of the component. So that's what I have, whereby I will have the relationship whereby the EMF is actually equal to the sum of the voltage, but the potential difference across the component itself. That's how I get the formula itself. Okay, so in a nutshell, what we have is we touch base with the what is the behavior of the current in the series circuit and the behavior of the potential difference of the components connected in series. So now we look at the third component here, where the resistors, okay, whereby they are connected in series. So what will happen to the resistance here? Now, to understand how, okay, I will not go through the mathematics behind proving how to use the formula. So we will look directly at how are we going to use the outcome to combine the resistance. Okay, so if you put the math aside, okay, so after that, we'll look at the rationale of finding the total resistance. Okay, the idea of having to find the total resistance is because I want to see whether I can lump the resistance together, can I replace the two resistance together or lump them into a single resistance to make the circuit more elegant. So imagine you have a circuit with 50 resistors. So instead of buying 50 resistors, I want to ask myself, can I replace these 50 resistors with a single resistor? Okay. Primarily, why? Is to make my job easier, because I only need to buy one instead of buy 50 resistors. And also, maybe I could save some costs. Okay, and the third one, which is the most important, is because 50 resistors actually occupy a certain space. So if I can replace the 50 resistor by a single resistor, I can effectively shrink the circuit board to become much, much smaller. Okay, I can make a component or the circuitry to be more compact, which is easier to carry, maybe it's more portable, maybe it's more user-friendly. So that's the idea of us finding the combined resistance, okay, the rationale between combining the resistance. For series circuits, okay, the combining is quite easy because the current remains the same. I will not bore you with the math like I mentioned. So the final outcome of combining resistance in series is just by adding them together. So which means I will have a simple thing. Let's say, for example, if I have a 2 ohm, R1 is 2 ohm, R2 is, let's say, 4 ohms. So how do I combine them, lump them together to become a single resistance with the same effect? So example, based on the math, I combine them will be 2 ohm plus 4 ohms. I will have, okay, let me write here first. So I will have 2 ohms plus 4 ohms. The effective resistor here will be 6 ohms. So effectively what I'm saying, that the 6 ohm resistor here, it will actually emulate the same behavior as these two resistors, these 2 ohm and 4 ohm connected in series. So now what I have is, instead of buying two separate resistors, connecting them together, I actually just need to buy a single resistor, which is 6 ohm. It could be cheaper because I only buy one only. And but most importantly, like I mentioned before, is that I can effectively shrink the circuit board from this space maybe to a much smaller space, okay, which allows me to maybe make it more portable or more user friendly. Okay, that's the main idea of me why we want to combine the resistance. Okay, now in the summary, what we are looking for is in series, they are we look at in a series arrangement, we look at the three components and the behavior of the three party in a series component I, V, followed by R. Okay, the three party that we have in a circuit. Current, because series, what we have is we have actually a single path. Okay, a single path, or sometimes I would say a single wire. Okay, it allows us to the current to travel. So that's why in a series circuit, the current is actually the same for all the points because the path is the same. For potential difference, it's like a bit slightly more complicated, but it follows the same thing because the energy from the power source will be used up by everybody. So in terms of voltage, which means the potential difference across the components will be the same as the source itself. So this is what I mean by the EMF, the power source of the item will actually be split across all the components. Whether all the components get equal potential difference or not, that is for a later part of the story. Okay, so but we all know that the total potential difference will be split up, okay, by the respective components. And lastly, the effective resistance, the total resistance, the final resistance that we have, we usually use it. We use the term effective resistance. Okay, it will be the fact that the sum of the resistance, it will be equal to the sum of the resistance. Okay, whereby R1, R2, R3, all you add up, you become one big gigantic resistors. Okay, and one of the common things that you have to remember, because I add up this way, the resistance, the effective resistance will always be greater than the largest resistor. Example, like I mentioned, if you have 2 ohms resistor, 4 ohm resistor, you'll find that the final answer that I have will be 6 ohm. So this number, the final resistor, will of course be greater than any of the bigger number, the bigger number here on the right side. Okay, so this is what we have for resistor here, for series arrangements. Okay, so run through the slide if you need to. Okay, the next segment that we look at will be on parallel arrangements. Okay, so stay tuned. Okay, any questions you have, please leave it at the comments bar at the bottom, so I'll get back to you. Okay, if not, okay, remember to subscribe to the channel to get the update for the new topics or new videos for the subsequent chapters or subsequent worksheets. Okay, so anything, just let me know. Okay, thank you very much. See you.